Hi everyone, welcome to Nursing with Beatrice. I am Beatrice and in today's video we'll be looking at burns. So what do we mean by burns? Burns refers to damage to the skin or tissues due to exposure to heat or what we call thermal, chemicals, electricity or radiation. Then look at the skin. The skin has two distinct layers. The outer layer is the epidermis and the inner layer is the dermis. The epidermis is the one that protects the skin from outside sources. Generally, when you are looking at somebody or you touch somebody's skin, you're actually touching the epidermis. This epidermis helps to hydrate the skin and it contains melanocytes that secrete melanin, which gives humans their skin color. For the epidermis, it's the inner layer of the skin. It contains blood vessels. It contains some glands, like the oil gland, the sweat gland. It also contains hair follicles. Now we look at the tissues. The one that can be affected is the subcutaneous tissue, which we call hypodermis. We also have muscles, tendons, and even bones, like in 3rd and 4th degree burns. The damage can be to that extent. For the causes of burn, we have thermal or heat. So that's direct contact, when the skin comes in contact with hot something, like hot metals, boiling liquids, or hot water. You know, so the patient can sustain burn from there. We have chemical burn. This can happen when someone accidentally either inhale the chemical or ingest the chemicals like acid, base. We have electrical burn. This is when somebody is exposed to direct electrical current. This can be a severe kind of burn because when you are looking at the person's skin, it may look like everything is okay, but it may affect the heart, even muscles or bones. We recall that the heart has some electrical activities going on for it to be able to pump blood. So when electrical current from outside source goes into someone's body, it can go straight into the heart, displace the electrical activity that was already going on, and the patient can be thrown into some cardiac arrhythmias. So we monitor this patient very closely. The final one is radiation. So for this, we can have it simple like sunlight. Direct sunlight can cause burn on the skin. We can also have it in some treatment procedures, like for instance, chemotherapy, where cancer patients are being treated. So this can cause radiation burn.
So let's look at pathophysiology of burns. As nurses, we need to understand what is going on in the patient that have sustained burns so that we understand treatment decisions and make proper plan. So now, some of the things I've mentioned here may not apply to every patient. It depends on the extent of damage. So for example, in first degree burn, we don't expect the patient to go through all the phases because it's just the epidermis that is affected. But in 3rd degree, 4th degree, due to the extent of damage, the patient may likely go through most of these phases that we'll be discussing. So the first thing that happens is increased capillary permeability. So it means the capillary become more permeable. What are capillaries? They are network of blood vessels. So now the blood itself is made up of plasma, the red blood cells, the white blood cells, and the platelets. And about 55% of the blood volume is plasma. So when plasma leaks out of the intravascular space, it goes to the interstitial space. It will affect the blood volume. The blood volume will decrease. And when blood volume decreases, the cardiac output will decrease. And then this will lead to increased viscosity of the blood. That means the blood will become thick. When this happens, the blood pressure will decrease also, because as the blood volume is low, the blood pressure will also be low, because the blood pressure is determined at least by the amount of blood that is flowing in the blood vessel. And also, body temperature will decrease, because as blood volume decreases, oxygen that is being circulated in the body will be low, and that will affect the body temperature. Also, plasma contains protein like albumin, immunoglobulin. So, and the protein, the protein, albumin, immunoglobulin, albumin is a component that may leak out of the plasma. And albumin helps in maintaining oncotic pressure. So when albumin leaks out, it's going to cause further accumulation of fluids, which is what we call edema. This will accumulate in the interstitial space. Next, we need to know is that the heart will want to compensate. How would the heart do this? The heart will increase the pumping. We want to pump more blood in order to sustain the body. And this is happening, that will lead to what we call increased heart rate. Also, hyponatremia and hyperkalemia may occur. For the hyponatremia, because of fluid shifts, the sodium in the extracellular compartment become diluted. And because of that, the sodium in the blood will be low. That's hyponatremia. And also, when the muscles are damaged, for example, the muscles may release some of its content, like myoglobin, and also release potassium. This process, when the muscles begin to break down due to injuries or rhabdomyolysis. When it happens, potassium in the blood becomes high. Another thing that may happen is that the body, in a way, trying to compensate itself. Since the blood volume is low, we want to divert some of the blood to more vital organs like the heart, the brain, and the liver. And because of that, the gastrointestinal tract may suffer low blood volume. And decrease in blood volume to the gastrointestinal tract will affect the gastric motility. The gastrointestinal motility will be low. And because of this slow movement, the intestine may suffer what we call paralytic ileus or intestinal ileus. So no activity is going on there. So when we look at the management of burn, you see the reason why we put patient on nothing by mouth, because of that decreased motility. And also because of the decreased blood volume, the gastric acid in the stomach will increase. It will be more concentrated, and that could erode the wall of the stomach, causing a condition we call colon ulcer. All right, so let's look at the classification of burns. We classify burns depending on the severity as first degree, second degree, third degree, and even fourth degree. First degree burn is called superficial burn. That means just the superficial layer of the skin, that epidermis, that is affected. This burn is painful. There's no blister formation. The blood supply is still intact because the blood vessels are in the dermis, and it blanches with pressure. So when you apply pressure to the area of skin affected, it turns white. When you release your hand, it turns back red. There's no skin grafting needed in this. Second degree is also called partial thickness burn. This affects both the epidermis and the dermis. This burn is painful. There's decreased blood supply because of those blood vessels that are in the dermis. The skin blanches also, is sensitive to cold air. And the most unique thing about this class of burn is blister formation. That is a round, shiny, fluid-filled vesicle. Very unique about this one. We don't bust the blister, we cover with sterile gauze. Third degree, full thickness burn. This affects not just the epidermis and dermis, also the subcutaneous tissue. That is the hypodermis layer. So here, the pain may be decreased or even totally absent, depending on the extent of injury. The wound is described as dry, waxy, leathery, or charred. And it comes in various colors. It can be white, black, or yellow. Fourth degree burn, called full thickness burn, this is the worst of it all. This affects both the epidermis, the dermis, the subcutaneous tissue, even up to muscle, tendons, and bones. Very serious. It has similar characteristics like third-degree burn, dry, waxy, leathery, and comes in various colors. Unique thing about this one is that it's painless because all the nerve endings are destroyed. And there's eschar formation, that is dead skin or dead cells or dead tissues underneath the skin or the area where the injury has occurred. This can cause compartment syndrome, can cause pressure in that area. So they may need to do some surgical intervention. This one, of course, requires skin grafting, just like third degree burn. So that wraps up the lesson for today. If you enjoyed this topic, please like, share, and subscribe for more educational content. Thanks for watching.